Only speak if your words are more beautiful than silence. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, in our Mindful Monday segment, we learn about things you never hear a highly intelligent person say. Enjoy.
Words are powerful and cannot be retrieved once spoken. They also have a way of defining our personalities, values, and principles. Sometimes verbal slip-ups occur because we say things without being aware of the subtle implications they carry. Understanding these implications requires social awareness, which is the ability to pick up on the emotions and experiences of other people. For this reason, intelligent people use words sparingly and also choose the words and phrases that best portray their message to give the desired response. There are some things you shouldn't say in public or around certain people because you don't know how they'll be interpreted. These phrases have the ability to make you look bad, even when the words are true. By avoiding them, you'll improve your communication skills instantly. Number 1. It's not fair. Well, life isn't fair, but saying it's not fair suggests that you think life is supposed to be fair, which makes you look immature and naive. Perhaps what happened is not fair. It may even be a terrible injustice. The thing to remember is that people surrounding us are often unaware of the incident, and even if they are privy to the scenario, proclaiming it's not fair does absolutely nothing to solve the problem. As difficult as it may be, focus your attention and efforts on resolving the issue. You'll feel better about yourself, maintain your dignity, and you may just solve the problem. Number 2. I told you so. This phrase is bursting with conceit and superiority. It's childish and immature. No intelligent, mature adult should utter such words from their lips. You may have warned someone of consequences of a certain action. Maybe they had it coming, whatever it is. Maybe they're even beyond the point of constructive criticism. Find some way to interact with someone who's made a bad decision that doesn't involve contempt. Maybe they need some help that you can't provide. Consider your options and act and speak intelligently. Number 3. You always, you never. No one always or never does anything. People don't see themselves as one-dimensional, so you shouldn't attempt to define them as such. These phrases make people defensive and closed off to your message, which is really a bad thing because you likely use these phrases when you have something important to discuss. Instead, simply point out what the other person did that's a problem for you. Stick to the facts. If the frequency of behavior is an issue, you can always say, "It seems like you do this often," or "You do this often enough for me to notice." Number 4. This is the way it's always been done. Who says that in this modern age of rapid change? Such a foolish thing to say. Technology-fueled change is happening so fast that even a 3-month-old process could be outdated. Saying this is the way it's always been done not only makes you sound lazy, but archaic. The fact that you are used to a particular process doesn't mean that's the only way in the world to get that thing done. An alternative way could lead to a much better outcome. Number 5. No problem. When someone asks you to do something or thanks you for doing something and you respond with no problem, you're implying that his or her request should have been a problem. This makes people feel as though they've imposed their opinion or request on you. You can replace that phrase with something better like, "It was my pleasure," or "I'll be happy to take care of that." It's a subtle difference in language structure, but the impact that it has on the recipient is beyond what you can imagine. Number 6. Whatever you want. Phrases like, "It's up to you," "I don't care," or "whatever you want" do not encourage conversation. Think about it. When you ask for someone's opinion, you really want to know what they want. If you really are indifferent, it's okay to say that, but you might add, have you considered this option? Or give some input without taking sides. Number 7, this will only take a minute. In reality, most of the time, it takes more than 5 minutes. So why use unpredictable words to deceive people? Saying that something only takes a minute undermines your skills and gives the impression that you rush through tasks. Feel free to say that it won't take long, but don't make it sound as though the task can be completed any sooner than it actually can be. Even if you are sure that it will only take a minute, value your worth. Number 8, good luck. This phrase is subtle, often well-intended, and is certainly subjective to one's own interpretation. It certainly isn't the end of the world if you wish someone good luck, but you can do better, because this phrase implies that they need luck to succeed. Remember, luck is what happens when preparedness meets opportunity, not something that happens by chance. So instead, say, I know you have what it takes, or you've got this. This is better than wishing someone luck, because suggesting that they have the skills to succeed provides a huge boost of confidence.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.